Can we start? Yeah? Okay. So, first of all, I would like to introduce myself. I am Alviso Benedetti. I am professor of applied chemistry at Cafosteri University. And I would like also to thank the organizer for giving me the opportunity to present our project. Okay. As a first talk, I would like to clarify the reason why my university, Cafoscari, is so interested in this kind of project. As you know, Cafoscari is Venice, so our university is built on the water. And so the interest in this type of research goes without saying. If we have a project with fishes, boats, water, waves, we are very, very interested, you know, because we are on the water. So any field related, any project related to this kind of subject could be really interesting for us. Okay, why this research is very interesting for us? Because it can open very interesting perspectives on very promising goals and purpose. Okay, you know, probably we have to explain. This is a movie, you know, this is a presentation. And I have no slides, I will talk only. But there is the translation in English. It's in Italian. So for technical problem, there is no any words. I'm very sorry about that. But sorry, I speak just a little once in Italian. Non è meglio farlo su YouTube e schizzare ogni volta? Okay, thank you very much. Okay, I try to, in any case, you can explain then, since you are one of the actors, you can explain what you have done during this. Here we have the two main actors of the movie, so they can explain, you know. And as I told you, this research is important for us because it can open very interesting perspective and on very promising goals and purpose. For instance, Cafoscari can be part of the cultural and industrial growth of the area from the North Adriatic Sea to the Po. This is the area of the Po Delta. It's the delta of a river. You know, there are many, many lagoons in this part of the region. And here there are the place where we can find our material, okay, native material, okay. And just to underline the importance of the project is that my university can work closely with the stakeholders, okay. So involved in the fish supply chain, okay. And together with them can tackle challenges related to the use of the sea shell waste. Okay, the main object is the same sea shell waste, you know. And not only opening new production or on the commercial change, but also creating new jobs. So this is probably the main reason why my university could be really, really interested in this kind of project. Okay, another interesting thing is that this project can be considered as a first step towards a circular economy approach. As you know, everybody talk about circular economy. It's a kind of magic formula, you know, but it's not so easy to have at the end a real circular economy process. So and now the implementation of a real circular economy model is more like a dream at the moment, you know. However, this is very important, we need to start acting on the single step. Okay, a circle is made by many single steps. The idea is to work on the single step and of the circle, okay? And to implement in the future a true circular economy process. So at the moment, the only thing that we can do is just to consider just a little part of my circle and to solve all the problem related to that. And only then we can talk actually about circular economy, you know, because it's not the nature is more the 3 billion years working on the circular economy, okay? The sapiens wants to do that in 10 years. It's not it's not the case. Okay, so another important mission of Kafoskari is also to prepare smart students, okay, to easily enter the world of work thanks to the project and the collaboration with the stakeholders and the creation of new jobs with having innovative skill, because this could be really, really important. We will only facilitate the university business connection. So another important step is the connection university business. Okay, the last part of my very short talk is I would like to say you something about the research, the problem related to the research just to obtain, just to proceed with this project. Okay. Apart the fact that in the last 2 years, my university has invested some millions of euro by instrumentation for materials characterization, and in the next few years, it is planned to increase the investment for which also the project could be benefit about that. But some very short information. Recently, we have published a paper with the title Valorization of Seashell Waste in Polypropylene Composites, an Accessible Solution to Overcome Marine Landfilling. Okay, so we have published this in the journal, European Polymer Journal, and we have studied as the waste of mussel and clam can affect the property of polypropylene. Okay, why this could be interesting? Because one of the problem concerns the fact that the shell of the mussel and the clams are made by calcium carbonate. Okay, so this is the materials in which we are interested, okay? But the problem is that the calcium carbonate has three different polymorphs: calcite, aragonite, and verterite. Okay, so usually you find calcite, you can obtain calcite from minerals. On the contrary, from the seashell waste, you can obtain also aragonite, okay? This is just, it seems a detail, but could be really interesting to see the difference between these two kind of crystal phases. And this calcium carbonate that it can be used, this is it's very easy to do that, is already commercial. There are many, many commercial products. Because the calcium carbonate has a positive effect on the mechanical properties of the polypropylene. In any case, notwithstanding the potential positive effect of calcium carbonate on the final properties of polypropylene composites, a complete investigation is still missing in the literature. So it's very important to go deeper about that. For example, using some X-ray diffraction analysis in our sample, we have evidence that, for example, the mussel shell powder contains both calcite 40% and aragonite 60%. On the contrary, clam shell evidence only aragonite. So this could be really interesting from some application. Okay. Another interesting property that we have found in our project is that it's worth noting that the increase of the muscle and clay shell powders in the polymer samples enhance the solar reflectance of the polypropylene, okay, thanks to the sunlight reflective properties of aragonite and calcite components in the shell. This is what it means. Actually, the total solar reflectance value passed from 10% for pure polypropylene to 40% of the composite, you know, gathered from the highly filled composite, thus providing a maximum cooling effect of about 2 or 3 degrees. And this could be another important thing. Okay, so this is only the beginning. We are working on that, and we are applying also for many project, European project. And I think this is all. So I can say that it's a very challenging project, and I leave the word to the next. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you. Hi. Sorry for my English, because I don't speak English in my work, but I speak only Italiano. But I try to explain it. I'm Stefano Berenton. I'm a biologist, but principal, I'm a farmer. My company work in the Delta of Po. That is probably the one of the best places where farmer the mollusk in general, but in particular clams and mussel. The clams have rather more or less 70% is a west. We hit only 20 or 30 percent of the mollusk. The other is a west. This is not only the problem after we hit, but when we work the clams, there is a big problem, because when we catch the mollusk, we management the west that is the producer during the work, because when I catch there is a 20-30% of mollusk that was died, and this was the only the clams. We put the clams on near our activity, no? And after go with the whales in the sand, okay, in the beach. Sorry, this is a problem for because during the every day, okay, the quantity is very very important. There is not the possibility to actually to do something with the West, because in Italy the West was animal waster, and our colleagues don't understand the importance of this West, okay. Every year there is more or less 20,000 tons that produce in our area, okay, of clams, 20,000 tons of mussel. If you think that the 70 percent was a waste is a very big problem. The problem is that this waste, come dire, impediscono, come posso dire, impediscono la tecnica. Look at the draw of our small shell, because the current is deviate, come dire. Esatto. Deviation. Come? The deviation of current of water, okay, because when the reproduction of our shell during the reproduction, the small clams don't survive in when go to the the bottom, no, because the waste block the small shell. Sì, and the oxygenation is also the oxygenation is blocked. Okay, of this. Cosa posso dire? This is the problem, and we know that this project will be a very important for the next evolution of our works. Okay. Grazie.
Thank you, Stefano. And yes, finally, I put together this type of innovation, starting from the problem that now Stefano is talking, the problem of the accumulation of this type of waste, seashell waste, is a big problem because also the Delta Po region, the region where Stefano work, and the region where this idea is grow. Is more or less the biggest area for the mollusk farmer in the Europe, probably a second only to Galicia region in Spain. But for example, for clams, probably this is the first area in terms of ton of production, such as with the number that Stefano talked about before. Starting from this problem, together with the consortium of mollusk farmer and the University of Ca' Foscari, we have put together, and I'm a polymer scientist and a consultant, a technological transfer in this field, in biopolymer field and polymer science field. I have put together this type of experience, starting from the very important study in physical chemistry carried out in the University of Ca' Foscari with the Professor Benedetti. We put this type of circular approach in this type of product. This product, what is? This product is a blending, a polymer blending between the waste millet, the seashell waste millet, and compounded with the polymer by a very scale-up technology. A very sustainable technology, the melt compound technology. Melt compound technology is a very diffuse technology. For example, when you coloring a plastic, you carry out a compounding technology, starting from the blending between a pigment and a polymer. Starting from this approach, starting from the polymer compounding technology, we started to study what is the principal characteristics of this type of waste. For example, some of this is talked before from Professor Benedetti. Starting from this type of characteristic of the milled seashell waste from clamp, from other type of mollusk, okay, we have study new product. Starting from this type of product, we have funded a team, Circular Venice team. This is the team, and in particular the brand, the trademark Circular Venice. Now Circular Venice is a trademark, also registered in OIPO, in European, from European Commission, and we have started to convey this type of idea, a circular idea, in order to develop a different type of good, put together plastic and biological product, in this case seashell waste. For example, in Isola Design District, thanks to the collaboration of Isola team, Gabriele Cavallaro and so on, we have put this idea also in some product, and in Materialize, in Via Passengo 7, we have, if you want, we have the possibility also to visit today or tomorrow this type of product. We have realized, for example, some component for the bicycle, or some component for the protection of the COVID screen, for example. But in any case, other type of product is in progress. Generally, the product that is possible to realize with this technology is a lot, because the granule that we see in this type of video is granule, or thermoplastic polymer granule, where inside of the bike is present the seashell waste milled. And we have the possibility to realize this type of compound with all the thermoplastic polymer. During the Materialize show, you have the possibility to see, for example, polypropylene or ethyl vinyl acetate mixed with this type of filler. For example, ethyl vinyl acetate is used a lot in the shoes industries, for example. Polypropylene is the principal component, for example, for the outdoor chair or for a lot of things. Also flooring and so on. Yes, for this reason, this type of approach probably permit to solve two problems. The problem of the accumulation of waste, that for the specific region of Delta Porridge is a very big problem. For the oxygenation, that before Stefano, as a biologist, has discussed very well, and also for the for other type of problem correlated also to the growth of this type of production, because if this type of waste accumulated in the year, and just now a lot of this is succeed, the problem can be improved, and this type of idea permit to reduce the amount of seashell landfill. In the second step, I think that this type of idea permit also to demonstrate that with the plastic it's possible to resolve a lot of problems. Generally, we see the terms plastic free and so on. I hate this type of terms, because I think that is a big error inside of this term. Plastic free is not possible. Okay, I think that with this type of project it's possible to demonstrate that with the plastic it's possible to solve other type of problem, because in this case plastic is a carrier of innovation, is a carrier for put together different type of biomaterial and realize new object, and also solving a problem for economy. In this case, this problem is a problem for the economy of this specific area, is a problem for the environment. I want to remember that Delta Po region is a very important region in Italy, also because the Po River is the biggest river in Italy, I think also the two biggest in Europe, after the Danubio, I think. But for this reason, also from the environmental point of view, from the biodiversity point of view, if we have the possibility to realize a little part of resolve this type of environmental problem, probably we make a good things. And yes, I think that also in terms of cross-contamination of the different type of professionality is a very interesting project. In this case, it is a very interesting project. In this case, I'm a polymer scientist. We work together with the fisher entrepreneur, fisher farmer, together with the university. We want also to replicate this type of circular Venice approach also in other area of the Europe. And for this reason, we work also for European project, for example, oriented to exploit this type of approach. Yes, this is more or less our idea that we have started more or less from 1 year in this type of activity. And yes, we are totally open to question, to. And I want also to suggest to visit also Materialize in order to see also some pieces of our idea. Thank you. Yes. Yes, because we have realized in PowerPoint in order to help the looping activity, okay, but. Okay, we have also the video with subtitle, I hope. This video is also posted in the community of Isola. Subtitle in English, I hope.
Ci troviamo nel delta del Po, la zona d'Italia più vocata alla molluschicoltura. Il 90% della produzione nazionale deriva dalle produzioni del delta del Po e dell'Emilia Romagna. Questa è una delle zone più vocate al mondo alla molluschicoltura. Nel 2017-2018 la produzione di molluschi bivalvi è stata dai 40.000 tonnellate, suddivise tra nibili 20.000 e vongole veraci altri 20.000. Queste produzioni hanno però un rovescio della medaglia, la gestione dello scarto. Vi è uno scarto sia durante la produzione che durante le successive fasi di lavorazione e poi al consumo finale. Il 70% del mollusco è infatti uno scarto, solo il 30% è la parte edibile del mollusco stesso.
La gestione dello scarto di produzione per noi imprenditori ittici è un problema molto importante, in quanto questo scarto viene reimmesso nelle zone limitrofi dei nostri allevamenti e impedisce di ottimizzare la nostra lavorazione, da un lato, e dall'altro impedisce l'attecchimento della vongola sostanzialmente e crea degli enormi problemi dal punto di vista del reperimento di vongola naturale. Attualmente infatti non esiste più la possibilità di trovare vongola in natura e siamo costretti a rivolgerci a degli schiuditori, ovvero a dei laboratori dove le vongole vengono create artificialmente.
Questo che ad oggi è uno scarto può diventare però una risorsa. Con il progetto Circular Venice siamo posti l'obiettivo di trasformare questo guscio di mollusco in un biofiller. Andando a macinare questi gusci è possibile ottenere dei nuovi additivi per la materia plastica. Il mondo delle materie plastiche ad oggi utilizza infatti molti filler, tipo il carbonato di calcio, il talco, che provengono però dalle miniere. La possibilità quindi di invece avere una risorsa di tipo rinnovabile come guscio del mollusco è quello che con il progetto Circular Venice ci siamo posti come obiettivo. In questo modo il guscio del mollusco può diventare un additivo per la creazione di nuovi biomateriali.
that actually in the world the mollusk production is very very requested because starting from the amount of the amount of mollusk now produced probably in Europe is not permitted to resolve all the request of this type of product now. For this reason, the problem of landfill and accumulation of this type of waste is a very very big problem, and probably our idea is an opportunity to solve this type of problem and candidate to the future of also of this type of activity of the farm. Thank you very much, and when you have some questions, I'm going to be.
Biodegradable, because you mix the mollusk waste with plastic, and after you create this new biomaterial, it's actually biodegradable or
okay.
It's not?
Yes, it's a good question. And now we have put this type of biofiller inside of standard fossil-based thermoplastic polymer in order to realize some type of product. But now we have started also to put this type of biofiller also inside of biodegradable and compostable polymer, biopolymer, and probably the presence of this type of biofiller can be improve also the bio-based content of the final product. Because this type of calcium carbonate is a biogenic product. For this reason, it's very interesting also to evaluate in new frontier of bio-based polymer and biodegradable compostable polymer. And probably the characteristic, the chemical physical characteristic of this type of product can be also accelerate the biodegradability. But this type of evaluation is in progress now. But absolutely is this type of biofiller is candidate also in this type of field of production of bioplastic. Thank you very much. Any question? Please use my microphone.
Thank you. What do you see as being the most promising application of the biocomposite?
Other type of application? Okay, a lot, because the plastic and the use of fillers such as carbonate, calcium carbonate, talcum, kaolin, and so on is very present come filler as filler, and our type idea, our type of filler, seashell waste can be replaced totally other type of traditional filler, calcium carbonate, talcum, kaolin from mines. From mines is not a renewable filler. Our filler is a renewable filler because we start to produce it from a waste. This is a big opportunity. For this reason, a lot of things. Before I have talked about the outdoor component realized in polypropylene and or in other type of plastic, polyethylene and so on. We have the possibility to use our type of filler and our type of project, circular venice project, inside of this type of product. But also in interior design component, in toys, also in automotive component. Now we are studying some compound, some biocomposite, also in case of final performances. For example, with polypropylene and with ethyl vinyl acetate, we had demonstrated that if we compare the neat polymer with the filled biocomposite, the final characteristic is the same. if you want to visit my materialize, we have the possibility to see, for example, the component of the bicycle, the seat of the bicycle realized with this type of EVA. Ethylene acetate, we have the component with neat EVA, and EVA filled with our filler, and we have the possibility to move from to push to move, and we have the possibility to verify that the final characteristic is the same. Our objective is to verify it. For this reason, probably not all the object is possible to realize combined polymer with our type of biofilm, but probably a lot, because I repeat that calcium carbonate talcum is used in traditional polymer, fossil-based plastic, but for example also biopolymer. And now, for example, a lot of biopolymer that is introduced in the market, for example, in the packaging sector and so on, is filled, in particular for improving the thermal performances, with filler. The possibility to use a biofiller is also, in this term, a very innovative solution.
I have a follow-up question.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Okay. Because it was mentioned before that there's an interesting sort of solar reflective property.
Yes.
So in terms of that, you know, being something kind of unique about introducing this new part to the polymer, like, are there applications that you think employ that as something unique in the outcome? Like, do you have ideas about how to actually bring that to life in what the final product is?
This type of result is a result that we have verified in lab scale, starting from a solar simulation, correct? Yes. And probably this application is very useful in the building sector, but now we want to realize some industrial prototype in order to confirm it. But probably if we have the possibility to confirm it, for example, this application is very interesting for in order to improve the wellness of the interior area, for example, because we have the possibility to reduce the temperature inside. For this reason, we can realize a paint, for example, filled with our product or other type of component in order to improve the wellness inside. Probably also the thermal efficiency of the house, probably. But this type of research is in progress, absolutely.
No, it's
the beginning. Yes, the beginning. We have also published it in the work that Professor Benedetti before has talked. It's in European Polymer Journal. European Polymer Journal. It's published more or less 5-6 months ago. Yes, we have the possibility to also to see the abstract in literature and so on. Also in collaboration between the University of Venice and the University of Pisa and the consortium of Mollusk.
Thank you.
Thank you, Son. Other questions?
I want to ask if you guys have a certain way of like, because if you are using the seashells, you have to crush them, refine them into fine powder, and then have a binder as bioplastic or biopolymer in order to bind them together as a binder. But is there like a more natural way, natural processes, instead of using that as a binder to bind the calcium carbonate together? Or is there another way of using the original shape of the seashell and to not make another process? Because when you refine those seashell into powder, into pieces, you need to have machinery, you need to have
milling
energies,
system.
You need to have to mill it. That basically creates another energy consumption within that processes while making it.
Yes.
I don't know how the process would be. How would you, like, see in the future, like, how can you refine this process of using the material instead of you have to grind it, you have to bind it with something else?
Yes. I wanted to talk about it. Some very important question. From we are also, before I have talked about European projects and so on, for this season we want also to verify the life cycle assessment of this type of product. We have compared the traditional use of the traditional filler, the traditional compounding with traditional filler, with our approach. For example, compare the calcium carbonate from mines, or talcum from mines, and our process, because the compounding of polymer is the same. Okay. For this reason, we our approach, starting from probably the residual waste, where the sea, the nature, just has worked with microorganisms, with the waves and so on, have reduced the pieces, for example, and reduced the animal part that before Stefano talked. Starting from this type of approach, our approach is more sustainable also in terms of LCA. We have evaluated 19 indicators, starting from equivalent CO2 until resource efficiency and so on, and we have verified together with an important research center that work in the LCA study that our approach is sustainable also in terms of environmental impact. In any case, now we are working a lot with the milling producer in order to optimize this type of technology, probably with two-step technology, in order to optimize the energy for reduction of water amount when we blend it together, and in order to optimize the energy needed for milling. And this is our approach now. In any case, thank you for your question. Our idea, the idea of Circular Venice team, is not only the use of this type of filler together with plastic. This is a very good opportunity where also the sustainability is maintained. But we have other idea where not only with the polymer as a binder, as you explained very well, but also with by the use of this type of residual filler as a added value product. For example, in cosmetic industries, we are working also in it, and in specific reference of it, and also in other type of filler. For this reason, we want to replicate our starting idea in growing also in other type of field. Probably now the polymer compounding is and the polymer based product is the product that permit also to enter in the market in a faster manner, because a lot of requests of this type of innovation is request now in the plastic sector. The request of sustainable circular based material is now is dominated the market. For this reason, also some customer push our in order to accelerate our type of idea, but also other type of project is started also with high added value of the waste of the resource in this moment, and probably also without the use of other binder. Also the relief, for example, for the protection of the coast is another type of study that is in progress. But yes, this is...
Oh, I have a following question with that as well. So in terms of that, basically you create a new material, right? And you are dealing with waste. And in fact that you create this new material binding seashell waste and then biopolymer, for example, is as a waste, and then you basically create a new product, new material. Have you ever thought of the end lifespan of like whichever the application you create, like in terms of how the end user or customer, after they finish it, is it gonna become, for example, interior design, that will goes into like construction demolition waste, and how can people discharge in within that end life, how do they discharge those waste?
Thank you for your question. Before I have talk about the possibility to blend this type of biofilm with thermoplastic polymer in order to melt compound technology. Melt compound technology permit to obtain a monomaterial, because when I put inside of polypropylene this type of our biofilm, I realized a polypropylene based material. For this reason, with this type of technology and with our type of approach, the final product, for example, before I talked about the component of bicycle or other type of component for outdoor in polypropylene, we have the possibility to recycle it because the final product is recyclable in the same manner that neat polypropylene is recyclable, because the compounding, this type of biocompound, this type of biocomposite, show the same characteristic in terms of recyclability of neat polypropylene, neat polyethylene, and so on. For this reason, when as a final in end of life of product, I have the possibility to recycle the material if is realized in thermoplastic, because the thermoplastic polymer is a recyclable material generally. For example, I put this type of biofilm in a biodegradable and compostable biopolymer, you know that biodegradable and compostable polymer at end of life follow the way of organic recycling in order to produce some compost. And in this case, our biofilm don't create a problem in the organic recycling way, because probably also our study is in progress. Also, the quality of the compost can be improved also. But in any case, the process of industrial compostability. For example, if tomorrow our activities in progress, also in this, we put together our biofilm with a PLA, with the certified as a biodegradable and compostable, the final biocomposite is also biodegradable and compostable. For this reason, in polymer field, some ways possible, the recyclability, and we maintain it, also the biodegradability and compostability. And the field depends, if packaging, if outdoor component, so on.
Thank you.
The monomateriality is the key of the knowledge of it. When before I put the idea that the polymer, the plastic in this case, permitted to solve this problem, we have also evaluated it. We don't want to realize a dissimilar material. We want to maintain the monomateriality in order to maintain also the sustainability. Because if this type of composite show that is a dissimilar material, the sustainability, the LCA that before I have talked, fall. Because this is another type of very important point that we have studied. Thank you very much for your question that permit me to explain also it.
Thank you.
I'm just curious to know, from the objects you have already produced with the filler, what is the amount composed by your material of the whole object? What's the amount
Of the filler inside? More or less, we are studying between 20% in weight and 30% in weight. This is more or less, but depend of the final performance that you want to reach. If you visit Materialize, we have the possibility to show, for example, the screen of the COVID screen. Okay, the mask. Okay, because a lot of things can become this type of business. But yes, in this case, we have realized a curve on the product. And in order to maintain the flexibility in this type of polypropylene, we have used this type of amount. But for example, in other type of of application. For example, now we are working in a vertical flooring before I've talked about in and more or less this outside in order to replace the wood used in the PVC. Okay, because now is a the wood plastic composite is a very large application. The use of this type of product can be reached also 70%, because in wood plastic composite the amount can be reached also this type of level. Depend.
Thank you.
It's very important to maintain also not only the performances but also the rheology. Our type of study also together with the university is also to study the processing. For this reason, we work with industrial machine, compounder and so on, but together with university, we have also the possibility to use lab scale, extruder, rheometer, in order to evaluate also the rheology and the processing of the material.
I have another question.
Yes,
it's about, you know, Venice and Murano, and Murano has like this famous glass production products. So I just wanted to know if you have think about or if any of the materials you obtain from the mollusk waste can be introduced
in
into
glass.
This glass market.
Yes. We have started, it's a confidential, but we haven't talked about because the question is...
Sorry.
No, but it's very important also to talk about. We are working together with the consortium. Esatto, translate is not difficult, but
amazing.
Stazione sperimentale del vetro is localized in Murano. Ecco, with them.
To buy glasses, you have to go to the Stazione Sperimentale. Yes. Okay. If you,
good to know.
We really appreciate this kind of tourist, not the tourists that buy only. Okay.
Yes, I think that is the biggest research center in glass in the Europe, probably more or less, because very very important with a lot of of equipment, and we have started to study together with the researcher of this center and together with Università Ca' Foscari the application of this type of circular Venice filler inside of glass.
Cool.
Yes.
Like to use the same waste to the like local production of glass.
Yes,
it would
it's totally
be really cool.
In this case, also for the plastic, we have our partner is also localized in more or less 30 kilometers, starting from. The sources?
Yes, but there are just to use this kind of waste in the glasses. It's important that this is waste do not contain some kind of element. For example, some metals like chrome or so on. Also, or some other iron. Why? Because they chromium because it's a problem. But for example, there are some elements that can change the color.
Yeah.
But we have done preliminary studies, and it seems that this seashell waste has not this kind of metals inside, so they can be used. Okay, mostly for artistic glasses.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So
that's
remember,
really
when you will come to Murano, please.
Yeah, I will. I was there like 2 months ago.
If you want to
I
put in contact with the researcher,
yes,
put in contact.
I have to go. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. Thank you for your question. This is another type of application. And at end of life, also in this case, the recyclability of the glass is maintained. Because we are also evaluating in particular, yes, the amount of different element present and... this is not a problem. In this case, also from an energy point of view, probably, also the dimension of the final powder after the milling can be also higher. For this reason, also the energy used for ELISA filler compliant for the glass industries can be not high. And yes, also in this term, in the sustainability and replicability in other sectors, in this case, the glass industries, the possibility is present. And yes. thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much to Isola to this event, and keep in touch.